Go, go.
My head! Damn it all! I swear that was the last time I drank with Redbeard. Oh, Sianna, a bloody long time it's been. You've changed.
Whereas you, not at all, big bad wolf. Though it seems you've started running with the wrong crowd.
And who should I run with, eh? Thumbelina? One shot and she's under the table. But the bed, what brings you?
You could always have a drink with us.
Oh, what now? Not on your life. I can barely stand, I'm so hungover.
You know what they say about the hair of the dog?
Out of the question. And why must you drink? Do you wish to drown some sorrow? And I don't mean to pry, but you don't look much like a young duchess to me.
They stripped me of my title and birthright, then banished me. A family spat, let's say.
Listen, looking for magic beans. Seen any?
I was given one for safekeeping, but...
Where is it? Talk!
Shh, not so loud.
Oh, I can be much louder than this. And resort to other means of persuasion.
Right there, the threats! Sianna to a T. Listen, I exist to restage a fairy tale. If you want to play at it, I'll be happy to oblige. But it won't be easy. The thing is, Little Red Riding Hood's popped her clogs.
What?
1,000 times they cut my gut open, filled it full of rocks and drowned me in the river. So once you stopped coming, I decided to repay the little imp for all her loving labor. Who knows at the bottom of the well, she and the hunter. Which means we can't play, and I'm under no obligation to talk to you. Not about beans, nor anything else. So leave me be. Sod off.
Wolf's pretty cranky.
Surprised? Think about it. He was cast in the role of the Nemesis without ever asking for it. It's a dog's life, I tell you.
So, what now?
Don't worry. I'll play with him. Or rather, play him. I just need that little red hood. A piece of apparel, that is. Not the poor girl's corpse.
That's a relief.
You wish to help me? Here's your chance. Jump in the well and fish it out. Well, chop chop.
All right, time to jump in the well.
Break a leg. Any luck?
Yep. Look what I got.
That would never fit you. Give it to me. How do I look?
Not bad. Not bad at all.
Let's go see the big bad wolf.
Let me guess. You'll play the granddaughter.
Mm-hmm. And you, the hunter.
You again? I thought I was clear. I will not talk to you if little Red Riding Hood is not with you!
Not a problem. Sianna can take her place.
What? Very well. It's not as if I can forbid you.
Granddaughter, come closer, sweetie.
But Grandmama, what big eyes you have.
They're better to see you with, my dear.
Granny, what big arms you have.
They're better to embrace you with, my dear.
And Grandmama, what big teeth you have. Eh?
They're better to eat you with, my dear.
Ugly and fierce. Remember what Joss said about the red bean? A human has it, and he definitely didn't swallow it.
Mm-hmm. Gotta open his belly. Bottle caps, fake teeth, a corkscrew. Ah, here it is. Red bean.
Well then, one step closer to our goal.
What?
I find myself wondering if you're just horribly discreet, or if those mutations completely scrubbed away your curiosity. Are you really not interested in what happened? In what became of me after they cast me out?
Well, since you brought it up, I'd gladly hear the rest. Let's see. I had escorted you out of the duchy.
Yes, and the noble knights of Toussaint and I didn't stop until we reached the Ketdu wilderness. They left me there alone, without a copper, in a torn lace dress, right when the frosts were setting in. They assumed something would eat me, or that I'd do everyone a favor and die of hunger. But as always, I failed to live up to expectations. I wandered the woods for a week, went purple from the cold, gnawed the bark from twigs. Finally, I saw a light among the trees. A campsite. They were bandits, bearded, drunk, spattered with blood. I was sure they'd rape me or kill me, or both.
Take it neither happened?
That's when I learned a robber and a murderer can be a better man than a knight in shining armor. They took me in, we set off for Nazaire, and I did what I could to repay them. I advanced in their ranks rather quickly. Eventually, I became their leader. Of the whole ragged band.
Been through a lot.
I have. And throughout this time, my sister was stomping grapes and shagging minstrels on down bedding.
She wasn't the one to banish you.
And I'm not angry at her for that. I'm angry at her because she forgot about me. Right. We've had our chat. Come.
Did you like Anna Henrietta?
You jest. I adored her. My darling little sis. So adorable. So sweet. Yet when they banished me from the palace, she didn't so much as peek out of the window.
She might not have known. Maybe just couldn't.
And could she also not grant me amnesty when she was crowned? Please. Three little pigs, Holmes. You know the story, don't you? Who's afraid of the big bad wolf?
Looks like Big Bad's already blown down the houses of straw and sticks. Rick's the only one left.
We should look inside. Remember Joss's words?
Mm-hmm. One bean lies out in the open, guarded by three nobodies. Yeah, could be it.
They didn't like that.
The big bad Witcher huffed and puffed, and look, got a bean.
It cannot be.
What cannot be?
You actually have a sense of humor.
Why so shocked?
Well, when you arrived, all you did was pout and mumble things in that gruffly monotone. And now this, a jest, and a good one at that. But here we are chatting away when there's work to do. We must keep looking. So, do you like it here?
No. Got a problem with magic in general. Illusions, portals, all that. Don't trust any of it.
A bow of old-fashioned tastes, eh? I like that.
Watch it.
This Longlock's tower?
Indeed. It's even taller than I remember.
Wait. What Joss said about the third beam, remember?
In the possession of a bold farmhand somewhere deep beneath the ground. Yes, this must be it. Let's go.
Flints when I was a lass, but no one bought them, so I branched out. Now I deal in snuffs, puffs, all sorts of fun things. What'll you have, sweeties?
Magic beans. Do you have any?
If it's not the new name of some kicker I already have, dearies, then no. But maybe you'd like some.
Hey, where'd you get that ribbon? That's mine.
Is that so? Then why was it lying in the bushes? Finders keepers, sweetheart.
Give Sienna the ribbon. Why not, huh?
Sugar Plum. The only thing I hand out for free is a first hit. To get them to come back for a second, of course. For all else, you've got to pay.
What if I asked you nicely?
Ask me nicely and I might play you for it. A round of cards?
Fine. I'll pay you for the ribbon. This enough?
It's enough. Now go away.
All right. Tell me.
What?
What you want in return. You're not doing this out of the kindness of your heart.
Don't want anything in return.
I... Thank you. Always grapple up her braid in the past, but I don't see it anywhere.
We'll find another way up. Could pull myself up here, and I'll have to make that jump.
If you say so, I shall wait down here if it's all the same. Climbing stuff by straw suit.
Prince's corpse. Tried to free Longlocks, but fell and broke his neck. Stumped to climb all that way for nothing.
So?
Got the bean, but Longlocks. Seems she got sick of waiting for a knight in shining armor.
Can you blame her? Men these days, dandies and fops all.
That why you cozied up to a vampire?
Detlaf was a tool, and only a tool.
Too bad he didn't know that.
I trust no one. Learned that long ago. Now it's his turn.
To use him. Was that your plan from the start?
No. At first, I was simply intrigued. Do you know the story? It was in Matina, a few years past. I'd gone there to pass some loot off to a fence I know. We were hashing out the terms when in walked Detlaf. He said he'd come to sell a silver candlestick. He gripped it through a cloth. That caught my eye. I followed him out, observed him from a distance, but he caught on quickly.
Yeah, superhuman senses will do that.
He turned down a blind alley. I followed. He jumped out from behind a crate, baring his teeth. I suppose he'd wanted to frighten me. Alas, he didn't in the least. After all, I'm a monster too, am I not?
A higher vampire and you were unimpressed? Don't know if that's brave or just plain foolish.
I've always had a way with ostensibly dangerous, quiet types.
That's supposed to be about me, too?
Oh, Mother, I hate to disappoint you, Geralt, but your belly button is not the center of the known world. Though, you do remind me of him a bit, stifling all emotions inside you, ever feigning indifference. You see, when I met Detlaf, somehow I knew, call it intuition, that he meant me no harm. That he was trying to frighten me off, for he, too, was scared. Now do you understand?
I guess. What happened then?
We talked, then met up once, twice, three times. Enough that he became infatuated. I truly enjoyed it at first, but only at first. He did not love like a man. But like an animal, madly, deeply, unconditionally, wildly. To return such a feeling, anyone would be hard-pressed. Let alone someone as twisted as I am.
So there came a day you just up and disappeared.
Yes. There was no other way. Let's just be friends, or I don't deserve you. He'd never have understood that sort of thing. But then, once I decided to return, clean up some old affairs, I remembered him, and concluded he could still be of use.
Playing with fire, that.
Definitely. And either I'll get burned, or I'll burn all else down. No other options.
Got a history with Detlaf now. So this meeting will be different. Not afraid?
I can handle him.
Mm-hmm. Sure about that?
You look at him as a witcher and see a monster. I know what he's really like. You needn't worry. It's time to go. Just a bit more work and we'll be able to say sot off to this fecking fable sphere. Now we must plant them by the path near Longlock's tower. Then prepare to meet the giant. Wait!
Why?
The stalk will sprout abruptly. Very abruptly. We must be careful. All right, toss them!
Something's always gotta go.
The home stretch. Admire the view later. First, we must deal with... him.
Fairy tale creature, that was one tough son of a wench.
I told you this land had gone ape mad, though I did not expect it to be so severe.
Can't help thinking you might have done that on purpose.
Why ever would I have?
To get rid of your guard, your captor. Getting close to the exit at this point. Probably think you don't need me anymore.
Well, you're wrong. You still stand to be quite useful to me.